Feeling hungry? How about wok fried chicken with pickled peppers? As potato chips. Chefs at PepsiCo's Asia R&D Center cook up new flavors and test them on Chinese focus groups.
Different in China is Chinese cuisine is we appreciate more and more the colors of the products, the colors of the food, and the texture of the foods. We love different textures, right? And then also the different flavors of the food we appreciate more and more.
As the world's second largest food and beverage company localizes, a growing legion of online sellers are tempting Chinese consumers' globalized taste buds.
People are now after more functional foods. For example, cakes as a meal replacement, with unique selling points like cute packaging. Online customers are mostly female, 18 to 35 or 40. They want taste, quality. Imports are trusted more because of food safety issues.
Whether it's Scottish salmon or French yogurt, Chinese consumers' tastes are globalizing, and that means a wealth of opportunities.
China's second largest food website, Douguo, has 3 million active users per day. The company is so bullish on the food business that its CEO has coined a term, kitchen economy.
Online food purchases are becoming more widely acceptable. Our lifestyles are busy. We get off work at 6, maybe get home by 8:30 p.m. The shops are either closed or fresh food is not so fresh anymore. The internet can supplement that. Our business model is to use our database of user tastes and habits to reach them with the products they need at the time they need.
Smaller packaging, you know, for on-the-go consumption. Products that, you know, can be meal replacement. For example, the breakfast occasion, we see more and more either in the beverage format or in a little can format, different types of products that are intended for convenient on-the-go breakfast.
Tianchu Capital, an investment fund focused on consumption plays, makes 50% annual returns. Duck necks, chili pickles, and steamed buns are some of the successful ventures backed by its chief investment officer, Feng Weidong.
The investment opportunities lie in taking regional foods national, like Zhou Heiya, who has famous street snack. After our investment, they expanded to Shenzhen, Guangzhou, Beijing, Shanghai, and grew very fast. Or Hangzhou's Ganqi Shi Buns. Buns can go national. It's a product that has the potential to unseat hamburgers.
Beyond national expansion, Chinese companies are also hungry for overseas food deals. Take Bright Dairy's Weetabix deal or Shuanghui's Smithfield buy. But Feng says Chinese companies are still at the paying dues stage.
Most Chinese companies still have manufacturers' mindsets. There's no brand premium. That's why there are price wars, which results in cost pressures, hence food safety issues.
The one constant in the Chinese food industry is change. Whether it's a penchant for imports, the craving for regional delicacies, or the online food buying trend, the world's biggest food market has plenty of appetite for spicy duck necks, French yogurt, or pepper chicken potato chips. Chen Lei for CCTV News.